आप सभी को नमस्कार। दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर संध्या फ्रॉम इंदिरा गांधी नेशनल ट्राइबल यूनिवर्सिटी अमरकंटक। एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट लर्निंग, लर्निंग थ्योरीज एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशंस। सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज वेरी वेरी रेलिवेंट एंड वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू ऑल ऑफ अस एज अ टीचर एंड एज अ लर्नर। लर्निंग इज इन कन्वेंशनल लेंस वी कैन से दैट लर्निंग इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ एसिमिलेशन ऑफ नॉलेज रिजल्टिंग फ्रॉम द इंटरेक्शन बिटवीन द टीचर एंड द टॉट। एंड द आइडिया ऑफ द ट्रेडिशनल टीचर स्टूडेंट रिलेशनशिप इज हाउएवर इम्पॉसिबल टू अचीव विद द ग्रोइंग डेमोक्रेटाइजेशन ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड द इंक्रीजिंग डिमांड फॉर लर्निंग और कंटिन्यूइंग एजुकेशन। So this is the very conventional meaning of learning, and we can describe the meaning of learning in different type of characteristics also. Like learning is a continuous process. This is very very simple, and learning is holistic process of adaptation of the world. Learning involves transition between the person and the environment. This is very important, and learning is the process of creating knowledge. And learning is the process, it requires the resolution of conflicts between diametrically opposed modes of adaptation to the world. So this is very simple meaning of learning, and we can describe learning in very simple manner, and according on the basis of the above points which I have given here, ki learning is a continuous process grounded in experience, and learning is a lifelong process also, because there is no need to only the formal environment you can learn, but you can learn everywhere. And learning involves transitions between the person and the environment, because if we are not transacting with our environment, then we cannot learn. This is very very important. And again, I have told to you that learning requires the resolution of conflicts between diametrically opposed modes of adaptation to the world. और ये लर्निंग ही है कि लर्निंग की वजह से हम लोग जो है कई सारी जो हमारे कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स होते हैं या हमारे जो कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर नहीं होते हैं किसी चीज़ के बारे में, वो अपने आप ही क्लियर हो जाते हैं। और बहुत ही सिंपल तरीके से ये भी कहा गया है कि लर्निंग मीन्स लर्निंग इज़ अ चेंज ऑफ बिहेवियर। लर्निंग एक ऐसी प्रक्रिया है जिसमें कि हमारे बिहेवियर के अंदर चेंज आता है, और ये चेंज हम अपना जो भी बिहेवियर शो करते हैं उसमें पाते हैं कि हमारा जो बिहेवियर है वो चेंज हो चुका है। लर्निंग का जो मीनिंग है वो लोगों ने अपने अपने हिसाब से दिया है, एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द मीनिंग ऑफ लर्निंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द कॉप्स एक्सपीरियंसल लर्निंग एंड इन द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्टिविज्म। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस द मीनिंग विच वॉज गिवन बाय लाइक कॉप्स अबाउट लर्निंग। कॉप्स का कहना ये है कि इन्होंने एक अपनी एक साइकिल दी कॉप्स ने, और इन्होंने ये बताया कि ये जो साइकिल है कि द साइकिल ऑफ लर्निंग एक्सप्लेन दैट द स्टूडेंट्स आर इनकरेज टू रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन देयर ओन एक्सपीरियंसेस एंड टू कम टू कंक्लूजन दैट मॉडिफाई देयर कॉग्निटिव स्ट्रक्चर। और ये कॉप्स ये भी कहते हैं साथ में कि जो बच्चा है वो क्या करता है, सबसे पहले जो उसके पास जो कॉन्क्रीट एक्सपीरियंसेस हैं उनके माध्यम से जो है वो सीखता है, यानी कि जो इसकी स्टार्टिंग है कॉप्स के अकॉर्डिंग, जिन्होंने एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग की बात की थी, कि हमारे पास, हमारे से मतलब ये यहाँ पर कि एज ए लर्नर कि हमारे पास कॉन्क्रीट एक्सपीरियंसेस होंगे, उसके बाद में क्या करता है स्टूडेंट्स मेक्स देयर ओन ऑब्जर्वेशन। कॉन्क्रीट एक्सपीरियंस के साथ साथ में हमने अपने ऑब्जर्वेशन दिए, फिर हमने उस पर रिफ्लेक्ट किया, और इसके बाद जो हमारा काम होता है ऑटोमेटिकली दिस प्रोसेस विल बी स्टार्टेड कि फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट कॉन्सेप्ट एंड जनरलाइजेशन। यानी कि सबसे पहले जो हमारे पास कॉन्क्रीट एक्सपीरियंस था उसमें हमने जो है ऑब्जर्वेशन किया, रिफ्लेक्शन दिया, अब हमने क्या करना शुरू किया है यहाँ पर फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट कॉन्सेप्ट एंड उसका जनरलाइजेशन। इसके बाद में हम लोग क्या करते हैं टेस्टिंग इम्प्लीकेशंस ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट इन न्यू सिचुएशंस। तो ये जो जो सारी प्रोसेस है कॉप्स के अकॉर्डिंग, जिन्होंने एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग की बात की, तो ये बताने की हमें कोशिश की कि जो हमारी लर्निंग है, लर्निंग इज़ अ प्रोसेस, एंड इसको हम जो है एक साइकिल के तौर पर भी समझ सकते हैं, जिसमें कि जो हमारी शुरुआत होती है वो कॉन्क्रीट एक्सपीरियंसेस के साथ में होती है, और लास्ट में हम लोग जो है जो भी हमारे इम्प्लीकेशंस होते हैं उनकी टेस्टिंग करते हैं, और फिर हम एक तरह से नया जो सिचुएशन है उसके अंदर जो कॉन्सेप्ट है हमारा उसको सीखने की हम कोशिश करते हैं। तो यहाँ पर अगर कॉप्स के अकॉर्डिंग हम लोग लर्निंग सीखने की कोशिश करें, या लर्निंग कैसे होती है हमने ये जानने की कोशिश की, और हमने ये पाया कि कॉप्स के अकॉर्डिंग एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग, एंड एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग के लिए एक साइकिल जिसमें कि हमारे 3-4 स्टेप, और ये स्टेप कॉन्क्रीट एक्सपीरियंसेस, स्टूडेंट्स मेक्स देयर ओन ऑब्जर्वेशंस, रिफ्लेक्शंस एंड फॉर्मुलेशन अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट एंड जनरलाइजेशन, एंड लास्टली टेस्टिंग इम्प्लीकेशंस ऑफ कॉन्सेप्ट इन अ न्यू सिचुएशन। सो दिस इज अबाउट लाइक कोप्स, अकॉर्डिंग टू द कोप्स वी अंडरस्टूड द मीनिंग ऑफ लर्निंग, एंड वेन वी टॉक अबाउट द मीनिंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द मीनिंग ऑफ लर्निंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द कंस्ट्रक्टिविज्म। सो कंस्ट्रक्टिविज्म रिफर्स टू अ प्रोसेस वेयर द लर्नर इज एक्टिवली कंस्ट्रक्टिंग बोथ द नॉलेज एक्वायर्ड एंड द स्ट्रेटजीज यूज टू एक्वायर इट, and the learner construct a new version of reality from his or her own unique experiences and deal with any new experiences in that field। साथ में ये कहते हैं कि जो हमारी कंस्ट्रक्टिविज्म जो लर्निंग है, कंस्ट्रक्टिविस्ट लर्निंग इज अबाउट द इलेबोरेशन ऑफ कॉन्सेप्ट। हियर आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट इलेबोरेशन ऑफ कॉन्सेप्ट एज दे ऑपरेट इन रियल कंटेक्स्ट। लर्नर्स एलेबोरेट कॉन्सेप्ट थ्रू क्वेश्चनिंग, क्रिटिकल एनालिसिस, एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट एंड बाई रिफ्लेक्शन ऑन एक्शन। इट मीन्स अकॉर्डिंग टू द कंस्ट्रक्टिविज्म लर्निंग इज इंक्लूडिंग नंबर ऑफ द थिंग्स लाइक क्वेश्चनिंग, क्रिटिकल एनालिसिस, एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट एंड रिफ्लेक्शन ऑन एक्शन। इसका मतलब क्या हुआ यहाँ पर कि एक लिमिटेशन हमें कहीं ना कहीं इसमें दिखाई दे रही है इस कंस्ट्रक्टिविज्म अप्रोच में, क्योंकि कि देयर इज द लिमिटेशन ऑफ दिस अप्रोच इज दैट इफ डज नॉट फुली टेक इनटू अकाउंट द वे इन विच सोशल प्रोसेसेस सच एज पीयर इंटरेक्शन, कोलैबोरेशन एंड द यूज ऑफ लैंग्वेजेस विच कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू लर्निंग। सो दिस इज द लाइक लिमिटेशन ऑफ दिस अप्रोच, क्यों देयर इज द लैकिंग ऑफ लाइक इंटरेक्शन, कोलैबोरेशन एंड पीयर इंटरेक्शन। सो द मेन एम्फेसिस ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्टिविज्म इज ऑन इंडिविजुअल डेवलपमेंट थ्रू द यूज ऑफ रिसोर्सेज एंड ऑन द एकोमोडेशन ऑफ न्यू एक्सपीरियंसेस टू एग्जिस्टिंग अंडरस्टैंडिंग। एंड हियर इन कंस्ट्रक्टिविज्म प्रोसेस द रोल ऑफ द काउंसलर इज जस्ट लाइक अ फैसिलिटेटर, and he or she facilitate learning through the provision of program task and to support individual development by creating a micro world। so there is no specific place for language, dialogue and communication in developing cognition। it means constructivism is based on the process of the cognition and the learning is also a process of cognition। and when we see the behaviorism theory then we find that the drill and practices approaches are in behaviorist approach, and we can see easily ki what is the behaviorist approach of learning and what is the constructivist approach of learning। when we talk about like a behaviorist approach of learning on the basis of the activities then we find drill and practices and tutorials are there, and in constructivist approach of learning independent learning, experiential learning and programming are there। and when we talk about learning processes on the basis of behaviorist then we find there are individual instructional and feedback, drill and practices, where in constructivism generalization skills based on the individual discovery। so this is a very minute difference between a behaviorist approach of learning and a constructivist approach of learning। so we should know like basic condition of learning also beside the above which I have taken, like behaviorist approach of learning and constructivist approach of learning। so there are some basic conditions of learning। first condition is contiguity, this is very very important। contiguity on the basic conditions of learning is contiguity, the almost simultaneous occurrence of the stimuli and of the responses to them. In teaching, we are always interested in making the students make connections between a particular stimulus and responses to it. This is very common process in the classroom, and this is the main objective of the like teacher also in the classroom, ki anyhow students make connection between a particular stimulus and responses. The second basic condition of learning is practice, and we know that practice is very very important for all of us for learning something. Like practice is the repetition of a response in the presence of stimulus, and we usually need to practice or repeat SR association. S means here stimulus, R response, association, to retain them for relatively longer periods of time. For new stimuli and new responses, more practices is required, and this is very well known phenomena in all types of learning. Under SR situation, practice is of the crucial importance, but it is of minor importance in learning concept or principle and in problem solving if the other condition of learning such as reinforcement are provided appropriately. It means practice is also must in learning process. And the third condition of learning is reinforcement. Reinforcement, this is a major condition required for learning to take place. Because of the complexity of the teaching learning process, and to learn something, and the complexity of the concept of reinforcement, and because of its importance, we shall here explain in detail. We can use reinforcement in different way to produce different effects. I can give the example also, the effect of different types of learning in the students in the process of reinforcement. And an organized learner is presented with a particular stimulus, for example reinforcements, before and after it elicit desired responses. In a given situation, the organism will tend to repeat the responses for which reinforcement is given, and to discontinue responses for is not. We can differentiate reinforcement from other stimuli because it has a particular effect on behavior. And the effect of reinforcement we can see in the theory of operant conditioning, which was given by Skinner. And the fourth condition of learning is feedback. Feedback is very necessary to learn something, and feedback is providing the knowledge that the response are correct or that they are require amendment. Also functions as reinforcement in strengthening the responses to be learned. And the term feedback refers to any information that permits learner to judge the quality of their performances. There are various ways in which feedback may be provided. The importance of supplying feedback has led to several technological innovations, including program instruction and CAI. CI means computer assisted instruction. Learning efficiency often increase when the students receive feedback about the quality of his or her work. If we are giving the feedback to the learner, automatically the learner will be able to learn that particular thing in easier manner. And the teacher, whether in the classroom, needs to make a systematic plan to provide feedback before moving on new learning materials. And available evidences indicates that active responses with direct feedback is superior to passive responses with indirect feedback. As a teacher, I think this line we should keep in our mind, ki what are the importance of feedback in the classroom when we are providing the learning material and teaching learning process in the classroom. Very weak reinforcement may be sufficient for controlling one's behavior effectively. If it is wisely used, we cannot say that a particular activity or event is in fact reinforcement until we have evidence that it has strengthened the behavior of the individual concerned. And the last conditions of learnings are generalization and discrimination. It means we are moving forward, we are moving towards to understand the things, and the last stage is generalization and discrimination. This is not the stage, but this is the condition of learning, ki automatically it will happen while we are learning something. And both generalization and discrimination are perhaps better defined as phenomena rather as condition of learning. We call them learning conditions because they are so closely associated with the basic condition of contiguity, practice and reinforcement, which are essential to all learning. A complex learning behavior can be described in terms of stimulus, generalization and discrimination. In many situations, we observe that a child, when confronted with a new stimulus, makes a response previously, learn to respond to a similar type of stimulus. And we call this behavior generalization. When a child is taught to call a particular color, like we can give the example like red, it is also learned to call other similar hues red. Under conditions where discrimination takes place effectively, the individual makes different responses to more or more stimuli. And we can give the example also here. A child can learn to select the color red, not as a pink. So this is the here we can discriminate like what is discrimination and what is generalization. Because first of all, we are discriminating the things. These are the different colors. And when we talk about like generalization, then we can say ki generalization is all our colors. So these are the some conditions of learning, and we should have the idea about approaches of learning also. And according to the approach of learning, learning is two type, deep approach of learning. Approaches of learning are basically two type, like deep approach of learning and surface approach of learning. यहाँ पर हम लोग थोड़ा सा देख सकते हैं कि जब हमारी अप्रोच जो है डीप अप्रोच होगी किसी चीज़ को सीखने की, तब हम क्या टास्क परफॉर्म करते हैं. व्हेन वी हैव लाइक सरफेस अप्रोच ऑफ लाइक लर्निंग, तब हमारी क्या अप्रोच होती है. अगर मान लीजिए कि अ लर्नर हु अडॉप्ट्स अ डीप अप्रोच, देन ही और शी इज इंटरेस्टेड इन द एकेडमिक टास्क एंड डिराइव्स एंजॉयमेंट फ्रॉम कैरिंग इट आउट. And learner searches for the meaning inherent in the task, and learner personalizes the task, making it meaningful to his her experiences and to the world, real world. And learner integrates aspect or parts of the task into a whole example, relates evidences to a conclusion. And a learner is having deep approach of learning, then he or she tries to understand the theories of the task, forms hypothesis. In another word, we can say that if learners want to grow by understanding, then they will adopt a deep level of strategy. So these are the some example of if learner adopts deep approaches. And generally we can give some statement also in this regard, if I am adopting deep approach of learning, then I can say I often find myself questioning things I read in books, and I generally put a lot of effort into trying to understand things which initially seem difficult. So these are the some example of deep approach learning. And when we have surface approach of learning, we have or learner have or adopts surface approach of learning, then he or she observes the task as a demand to be met or as a necessary imposition if some other goal is to be reached. And learners see the different aspect or parts of the task as unrelated to other tasks. And a learner considers the time required to complete the task without searching for the maintaining inherent in the task. Learner relies on memorization, tries to reproduce the surface aspect of the task. And we can say in another word also, if a learner wants to display symptoms of having learned something, she will adopt a surface level approach. So this is the these are the basic differences between deep approach of learning and surface approach of learning. According to the environment we are adopting, and we adopt surface level approach of learning and deep approach of learning. So it means ki learning is having a very specific definition, and the concept of learning is very broad, because in simple word we can say learning is a change of behavior, but in like according to Coates and constructive approach, there is a different meaning of learning. And learning is having some certain like some conditions also, and there are the types of the learning approach, like deep approach of learning and surface approach of learning. And it has been observed that the students adopted approaches to the task they undertook according to their experiences of the those specific occasions. This is very true, ki according to the situation we are adopting the like approaches of learning. So this is all about this is the like basic concept of learning, ki what is the meaning of learning, and what are the characteristics of learning, what are the conditions of learning, and what are the approaches of learning. So right now I am going to talk about some theories of learning, and here I am taking only few theories, like behaviorism theory of learning and cognitive theories of learning, and I give some reflection on Gagne hierarchy of learning also. So I am here to talk about behaviorism, and behaviorist view means behaviorism is the among the most dominant of modern theories of learning. The behaviorist view is quite comprehensive and includes a variety of thoughts, but all these thoughts suggest a common approach of learning in terms of the development of connections between stimuli received and responses displayed by organism or by a learner. After conducting laboratory experiments with animals, behaviorists concluded that learning is a process by which stimulus and response bonds are established when a successful response immediately and frequently follows a stimulus. It means they are emphasizing only on the connection of stimulus received and responses displayed. And they assumed that people are similar to machines. So this is the like assumption of like behaviorist, and considered irrelevant any reference to the role of the mind. Most of the basic behavioral researches has been conducted on animals. This is very true, and the application of these researches studies however relate to a wide range of human behaviors. And in this context we can summarize the major principle of the theories to key behaviorists such as Thorndike, Pavlov and Skinner. And these theories have most influence upon the development of theory of design. So here I am talking about Thorndike, Pavlov and Skinner. And according to behavioral theory, learning is viewed as the ability to perform new behavior which are established as goal. Again I am repeating the same sentence. Behavioral theories, learning is viewed as the ability to perform new behavior which are established as goal. New behavior is connected with like established as goal, and there is an effort to create condition which will enable the learner to demonstrate these behavior. I'm talking about the behaviorist Edward L. Thorndike, and he has given three laws. All of us are knowing very well what are the like laws which was given by Edward L. Thorndike towards learning, and these laws are law of effect, number one, and law of readiness, and law of exercise. So what is the concept of these laws, and how they are affecting our learning process? According to A. L. Thorndike, the law of effect stresses the importance of the effect of a stimulus response. It means it stresses the importance of stimulus and response. Satisfying results reinforce the response, while inadequate results weaken. Reward and punishments are therefore important ingredients of the learning. This is very very important according to the Edward Thorndike, ki reward and punishment are very important ingredients of learning. While the law of readiness indicates the learner's willingness to make SR connections, while the law of exercise is related to the strengthening of the connection through practices. So these are the law which was given by like E. L. Thorndike, how we are learning something and how we can use these laws in learning process. Behaviorists suggest that learning something is a process similar to habit formation through conditioning, which links desired response to stimuli, a prominent theory amongst them in B.F. Skinner, who propagated the concept of apparent conditioning. But before describing the theory of Skinner, B.F. Skinner, operant conditioning, I would like to draw the attention on the educational implications of behaviorism theory of learning. The behaviorist approach of learning has greatly influenced modern educational practices, and behaviorists have conceived of teaching as a manipulation of the environment in order to produce desired behavioral changes in learners and thus make education more effective. And behaviorists suggest the adoption of the following three principles towards making a teaching learning transactions yield desirable results, like knowledge of result and use of positive reinforcement, minimum delay in reinforcement, and elaboration of complex behavior by dividing learning into a series of small steps. And one of the major contributions of behaviorist to education is their emphasis on defining objectives in behavioral terms. Earlier I have talked about use of positive reinforcement and minimum delay in reinforcement and elaboration of complex behavior, but right now I'm talking about defining objectives in behavioral terms, and this is the implication of behaviorist theory. That's why we are defining objectives in behavioral terms. And behaviorists have stressed the need for stating objectives in the form of overt behavior which can be observed and measured. The role of teacher becomes very crucial in deciding what changes of behavior the learner should display when they learn, and in teaching in such a way that learner can attain those behavioral changes. And behaviorist principles have also influenced contemporary approaches to evaluation. For example, Bloom has suggested a model of taxonomy of educational objectives based on the hierarchy of learning objectives. And another example of the educational uses to which a behaviorist can be put is individualizing instructions, such as personalized system of instruction based on reinforcement theory that has been widely used in education. It means writing objectives in behavioral terms and computer assisted instruction, teaching machines are the effect of behaviorism theory of learning. And right now I'm going to talk about Skinner theory of operant conditioning. In earlier presentation, in behaviorist theory I have talked only stimulus and response, and there is a connection of stimulus and response, then learner will achieve the goal. But in operant conditioning, there is one word is added: stimulus, response, and reinforcement. According to Skinner, learning is a change in behavior as the learner learns his or her responses in terms of changed behavior increases. And operant conditioning is a learning force which affects the desired responses more frequently by providing a reinforcing stimulus immediately following the response. The most important principle of this type of learning is that behavior changes according to its immediate consequences. I'm talking about consequences. Pleasurable consequences strengthen behavior while unpleasant consequences weaken it. For example, in Skinner's famous experiment, a pigeon picks the red ball and gets food, because here food is reinforcement, and the pigeon is likely to pick the same ball again and again just because food is working as a reinforcement to the pigeon. And in operant conditioning learning, activities are divided into many small steps and reinforced one by one. It means in operant conditioning we have divided the activities in small steps, and in every steps we are giving the reinforcement. The operant behavior or act is strengthened so as to increase the probability of its recurrence in future. And here three external conditions are reinforcement, contiguity, and practice. And these three external conditions must be provided to promote to effect operant conditioning. I think we should talk about reinforcement also here in a like a broader manner, because reinforcement is the most important aspect of Skinner theory of learning. And an organized learner is presented what he presented with a particular stimulus or reinforcer after it makes a response. Here, stimulus, reinforcer and response. It means reinforcer is coming in between stimulus and response. Response will come after having the reinforcement. In a given situation, the organized learner will tend to repeat responses for which it is reinforced. Skinner made a distinction between positive and negative reinforcement. And we should have the knowledge about this thing also, ki what is the meaning of positive reinforcement and what is the meaning of negative reinforcement. When we talk about positive reinforcement, then we find that ki positive reinforcement is a stimulus which increases the probability of desired responses. Desired responses means positive responses. I'm talking about the reinforcement, and Skinner has given two type of the reinforcement, like positive reinforcement and negative reinforcement. Positive reinforcement means kya aapka ki positive reinforcement is a stimulus which increase the probability of desired responses. Usually it is a positive reward. Praise, smiles, prizes, these are the example of positive reinforcement. While in negative reinforcement, the desired behavior is more likely to occur if such stimulus reinforcement is removed. For example, we can close window and doors to avoid hearing loud noises, or we can avoid wrong answer by giving right answers. So here noise and wrong answers are negative reinforcements. That negative reinforcements is a negative reward, the avoidance of which gives us relief from an unpleasant state of affairs. Skinner did not equate negative reinforcement with punishment. It means he has given the idea that reinforcement is a separate thing and punishment is a separate thing. And reinforcement may be positive and reinforcement may be negative also, but it is totally differ from punishment. So the basic when we summarize the Skinner theory of operant conditioning, then we can say ki we can categorize in some basic elements, like when the basic assumption of operant conditioning of Skinner is ki behavioral changes is a function of external environment, conditions and event. It means they are focusing on external environment condition. And they have given the idea about the learning means. Learning means change in behavior represented by a visible responses. While they have given the idea about learning outcomes, especially Skinner, in operant conditioning, learning outcomes are new responses and new behavior. And according to Skinner, components of learning are stimulus, response, and reinforcement. And and what are the applications of operant conditioning are ki we can analyze the readiness and practices motivation and individual learning materials, teaching machines, and analysis of aversive classroom practices and interaction classroom situation. And we can schedule the reinforcement for transfer of response stimulus relationship to the solution of a new problem. So this is all about the basic summary of operant conditioning, which was given by Skinner. And in this behaviorist theory, like operant conditioning, stimulus, reinforcement and response. So these are the three things are very important in operant conditioning of Skinner theory. And so this is all about behaviorism theory of learning. And I'm coming on my third part of this my presentation, like cognitive approaches of learning. कॉग्निटिव अप्रोच के अंदर भी बहुत सारी लर्निंग को के अलग अलग तरीके बताए गए कि लर्निंग का मीनिंग क्या है। और अभी तक जो हम लोगों ने बिहेवियरिज्म थ्योरी को पढ़ा, तो वहाँ तक हमने ये जानने की कोशिश की है कि जो बिहेवियरिस्ट हैं वो ये कहते हैं कि SR जो रिलेशनशिप है दैट इज़ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। एंड फिर स्किनर बाद में ये कहते हैं कि सिर्फ स्टिमुलस और रिस्पॉन्स से काम नहीं चलेगा, बल्कि हमें रीइन्फोर्समेंट पर भी ध्यान देना पड़ेगा। साथ साथ उन्होंने ये भी कहने की कोशिश की कि जो एक पॉजिटिव रीइन्फोर्समेंट है, एक निगेटिव रीइन्फोर्समेंट है, लेकिन रीइन्फोर्समेंट इज टोटली डिफर फ्रॉम लाइक पनिशमेंट, दिस इज नॉट द पनिशमेंट। और साथ में उन्होंने ये भी बताया कि जो पर्सनलाइज इंस्ट्रक्शन है, हम उसे कैसे रीइन्फोर्समेंट के थ्रू, मतलब डिजायरेबल बिहेवियर को हम कैसे बढ़ा सकते हैं। अभी हम लोग बात करने जा रहे हैं कॉग्निटिव अप्रोच ऑफ लर्निंग की। एंड द कॉग्निटिव अप्रोच डील्स मेनली विद द साइकोलॉजिकल आस्पेक्ट ऑफ ह्यूमन बिहेवियर। अभी तक हम लोग सिर्फ बिहेवियर की बात कर रहे थे, लेकिन जैसे ही हम लोग बात करते हैं कॉग्निटिव कॉग्निशन अप्रोच या कॉग्निटिव अप्रोच की, तो इसमें क्या है यहाँ पर कि इट हैज़ पुट बैक ऑन द एजेंडा द नेचर ऑफ द कॉम्प्लेक्स मेंटल प्रोसेसेस ऑफ अ लर्नर। मीन्स इफ वी आर लर्निंग समथिंग, सो इट मीन्स एनी थिंग वी आर रिसीविंग फ्रॉम द आउटर इन्वायरमेंट, इट विल गो इन आर कॉग्निशन एंड देयर इज अ प्रोसेस लाइक दिस प्रोसेस इज नोन एज मेंटल प्रोसेस। आफ्टर दैट द लर्निंग आउटकम्स विल कम। वाइल कंडक्टिंग एक्सपेरिमेंटल इन्वेस्टिगेशन कॉग्निटिविज्म टेक्स इंटू कंसिडरेशन एक्टिविटीज। अकॉर्डिंग टू कॉग्निटिव अप्रोच सम एक्टिविटीज आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लाइक परसेप्शन, कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर्मेशन, लैंग्वेज यूज, थिंकिंग, अंडरस्टैंडिंग, प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग, अटेंशन एंड मेमोरी। सो द कॉग्निटिव अप्रोच इज कंसर्न विद द इंडिविजुअल इनर साइकोलॉजिकल फंक्शनिंग एंड इट स्ट्रांगली कंटेंट्स द बिहेवियरिस्ट एम्फेसिस ऑन ओवर्ट बिहेवियर। हियर आई वुड लाइक टू से बिहेवियरिस्ट एम्फेसाइज ऑन ओवर्ट बिहेवियर, वाइल जो कॉग्निटिविस्ट एम्फेसाइज ऑन इनर बिहेवियर ऑफ द लर्नर। एंड कॉग्निटिव थ्योरिस्ट हैव मेड इन्वेस्टिगेशन टू शो दैट पीपल लर्न बाय परसीविंग, कॉम्प्रिहेंडिंग एंड कंसेप्चुलाइजिंग प्रॉब्लम। सो दीज आर द थ्री इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग विच वॉज गिवन बाई कॉग्निटिविस्ट कि दीज आर द वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट कि वी आर लर्निंग समथिंग, इट मीन्स वी आर परसीविंग, कॉम्प्रिहेंडिंग एंड कंसेप्चुलाइजिंग प्रॉब्लम। द कॉम्प्रिहेंशन ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट एंड रूल्स इट्स ट्रांसफरेबल टू द सोल्यूशन ऑफ न्यू प्रॉब्लम और फ्रॉम वन सिचुएशन टू अनदर। द कॉग्निटिविस्ट आर्ग्यूइंग दैट पीपुल ग्रेस्प थिंग एज ए होल आर देयर फॉर अपोजिंग द बिहेवियरिस्ट अप्रोच टू टीचिंग विच एम्प्लॉयज डेल्स टू मेमोराइज द इंफॉर्मेशन। कॉग्निटिविस्ट बिलीव दैट लर्निंग इज अ क्वेश्चन बोथ ऑफ इनसाइट फॉर्मेशन एंड ऑफ सक्सेसफुल प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग एंड नॉट अ मैकेनिकल सिक्वेंस ऑफ स्टिमुलस एंड रिस्पॉन्सेज। हियर वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड कि हाउ दे आर लाइक विड्रॉइंग द कॉन्सेप्ट, हाउ दे आर विड्रॉइंग द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ बिहेवियरिज्म कि इन बिहेवियरिज्म ओनली स्टिमुलस रिस्पॉन्स सिक्वेंस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, बट दे आर हियर सेइंग कि दिस इज इनसाइट फॉर्मेशन एंड सक्सेसफुल प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग। मीन्स लर्निंग इज नॉट अ मैकेनिकल प्रॉब्लम, मैकेनिकल लाइक फॉर मैकेनिकल प्रोसेस। एंड दे हैव गिवन द आइडिया अबाउट इंफॉर्मेशन प्रोसेसिंग कि कैसे हमारा जो इंफॉर्मेशन की प्रोसेसिंग कैसे होती है। लाइक दे आर ओनली दे हैव दे बिलीव कॉग्निटिविस्ट हैव बिलीव दैट कि इनसाइट फॉर्मेशन एंड सक्सेसफुल लाइक प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग। एंड दे हैव ऑल्सो गिवन द आइडिया कि लर्निंग इज नॉट अ मैकेनिकल सिक्वेंस ऑफ स्टिमुलाई एंड रिस्पॉन्सेज। एंड दे हैव डिस्क्राइब इंफॉर्मेशन प्रोसेसिंग कि कैसे इंफॉर्मेशन की प्रोसेसिंग होती है, जस्ट लाइक कंप्यूटर कि हमने कुछ भी इनपुट किया उसमें और उसमें एक ऑपरेशन होता है, फिर उसके एक तरह से आउटपुट होता है। सेम सिस्टम आर माइंड इज फॉलोड लाइक इंफॉर्मेशन प्रोसेसिंग सिस्टम। वो कह रहे हैं कि जो इन्फॉर्मेशन प्रोसेसिंग सिस्टम है, सबसे पहले हम थोड़ा सा बात करेंगे उसमें कि भाई इन्फॉर्मेशन कहाँ जा रही है, हमारी मेमोरी के अंदर। तो वो कह रहे हैं कि वी हैव थ्री टाइप ऑफ मेमोरी। फर्स्ट वन इज सेंसरी मेमोरी एंड सेकेंड इज शॉर्ट टर्म मेमोरी एंड द लास्ट इज लॉन्ग टर्म मेमोरी। द सेंसरी मेमोरी रिसीव इन्फॉर्मेशन into the system either visually or in auditory form. And this type of memory refers to the active mental process by which knowledge is coded or represented. So this is the sensory memory. And while we talk about short-term memory, it refers to the process by which knowledge is organized, is stored and accessed. And the long-term memory, it refers to the mental process by which the information is integrated with previously stored information in short-term memory. When an average person speaks of something behind learned, the implication is that the knowledge has been put into the long-term memory. One of the most important aspects of long-term memory is that it can be consciously controlled. And information processing is a psychological activity consisting of information being received by the senses and information item being selected and passed on the like short-term memory, where encoding processes transfer them to the long-term memory. Long-term memory provides a store from where information can be retrieved in order to make a response. And process may be, we can like understand this process by the diagram also. First of all, stimulus. We are receiving the stimulus and it will go in our sensory motor part. Then it will go to the short-term memory part, then will go to the long-term memory part, then it will come forward in the form of the responses. It means thinking is essentially a purposive activity and learning is therefore an intelligent and active process. Within this process, issue of preparation are very, very important, because perceptual activity is the first relationship between a person or his or her environment or situation. The individual interact with the situation, and this interaction, it means I'm interacting with my situation on environment. So this interaction lead to the relatively in perception, he or she organizes the stimulus into meaningful pattern. So an individual acquires knowledge through his or her interaction with the environment and store this knowledge for use in new situations. So this is all about like how the information processing is going on in any individual, or what is the meaning of like information processing learning. कि learning का information processing कैसे हो रही है, कि कैसे वो जो है वो receive हो रहा है short term sensory mode से, फिर वो जा रहा है आपका short term में, फिर वो long term में, और फिर जो है वो एक response बनकर हमारे सामने आया. और जो जो हमारे cognitivist हैं वो ये भी कहते हैं कि learning is a cognitive process. पहले भी हम लोग इस चीज़ की बात कर चुके हैं कि कॉग्निटिव प्रोसेस है जिसमें कि परसेप्शन है और कई सारी और भी स्टेप्स हैं, उसके बाद में हमारी लर्निंग होती है. तो इट मींस लर्निंग गोल्स आर नॉट अचीव सिंपली बाय परफॉर्मिंग एक्टिविटीज, बट बाय ग्रेस्पिंग द मीनिंग ऑफ थिंग्स इन अ वे दैट कैन बी ट्रांसफर टू द सोल्यूशन ऑफ न्यू प्रॉब्लम्स. एंड हियर in cognitive process, feedback is very, very important, and this is the important element of the like learning, especially when we say ki learning is a cognitive process. And the learning situation is seen as one in which an individual confront a problem, develop a hypothesis based on the knowledge already present in his her memory, and then tries it out. The consequences of learner action then provide with the required feedback so that the correct solution are confirmed and the incorrect ones rejected. It means the learning is a cognitive process and feedback is very, very important. According to the feedback, learner can understand the things in a like confirmed manner, and if we are giving the wrong feedback to the learner, so he or she is not able to understand the things in a like in proper manner. Cognitive theory are very, very important, and these are having also educational implications. And the major emphasis of this like cognitive approach is on how to design educational activities in order to promote cognitive learning. Here, I am emphasizing the major emphasis of this approach is on how to design educational activities in order to promote cognitive learning. While in like a behaviorist approach, we learn how to write behavioral objectives, but here we are talking about the designing of the educational activities to promote cognitive learning. And how we can promote like cognitive learning in this approach, the ability to retain knowledge depends on how well it understood. Understanding can help us conceptually locate the information we store in our memory and create new cognitive structures to efficiently use our long-term memory in new situations as well. And teaching material should be planned on the basis of the theory of discovery. So this is the main thing, ki if we are using cognitive approach or cognitive theory of learning, then we should plan ki how we can give the material in the classroom. And instructional methods should therefore emphasize the learner's competencies for spontaneous discovery, which implies that active learning methods should be adopted to motivate the learner to rediscover the facts or find solution to the problem. So this approach emphasizes appropriate decision regarding the instructional objectives, the analysis of prerequisite behavior, and the teaching method. And this approach, means cognitive approach, also stresses problem-oriented learning by raising problems and then solving them. It tells us how to teach in a reflective way, and it also emphasizes the study of learner characteristics, which can be used by the teacher to expand the quality and of the student's insights. So these are the educational implications of cognitive theory of learning. And cognitive theory of learning, one psychologist was also there, Bruner, and he has given the discovery learning. And his approach to psychology is eclectic. He looked at human being as an information processor, thinker, and creators, and treat the learner as a reactive organism who actively select, structure, retain, and transforms learning to achieve certain goal. It means he was used the word organism instead of learner, and he suggested that people have primary needs other than animal drives. Here we can we are human being and an animal. So there is a basic difference between human being and animal, because animals are not having any type of curiosity, but we have curiosity. That's why we are human being and they are animal. And curiosity keeps an organism active even in the absence of organic states of tension. So our cognitive activity is not always dominated only by the need of the such thing like food and food, sex, etc. And according to Bruner, learning as a goal directed activity which satisfied this drive and answered the curiosity of the learner. He also suggested that the learning is a cognitive process, but he has given the idea about discovery theory of learning, ki how we are discovering and inquiring the things. And in the Bruner way, the cognitive process has three simultaneous process, like acquisition of new knowledge, number one. Number two, information transformation of acquired knowledge. And number three, checking the adequacy of new knowledge. The modes of cognitive developments are described by Bruner in terms of three hierarchical levels, or we can say that modes. The first mode is called inactive. It is the representation of knowledge through actions. For example, a child who inactively knows how to ride a bicycle may not be able to describe the procedure. And the second mode or level is iconic. First is inactive and second is iconic according to the Brunner. And iconic is based upon the internal imaginary. And knowledge is represented by a set of images, graphics, drawing that stand for a concept but do not fully define it. And lastly, he used the word symbolic. यानी कि first one iconic, first inactive, second iconic, and third one is symbolic. And it is the use of symbolic means it is the use of words and other symbols to describe a concept or an experience. Or symbolic representation is based upon an abstract, arbitrary, more flexible system of thought. And at this stage, language become more important. So here he has emphasized that language more important in cognitive process also. And he also opined that learning is an autonomous process. Autonomous कैसे हुआ यहाँ पर? He suggested that when the learner is allowed to approach learning as an act of discovery, then learner will increasingly engage him or herself in learning with the autonomy of self-reward. In other words, the learner provides for his or her own stimulation and in this way arouses his or her own curiosity. It means they are giving the autonomy to learn the things, and Brunner and his associate indicated that learner can be taught to generate their own instructional method and strategy for learning. But it means he is totally emphasizing on like autonomy of learning, ki how learner can enhance their curiosity and how they can learn. Brunner argues that the teacher's role here must be to create an environment in which learners can learn on their without the help of any pre-packed information. And he also suggested that learners should also learn through active involvement with content. His work was thus influential in the open school movement and other humanistic approaches to the learner. But the most important goal of education, Brunner felt, is to teach learner how to value learning for its own sake, enabling them to acquire on their own knowledge they need. According to the Brunner, learning should be flexible and exploratory, and institutions should arouse learners' curiosity, minimize the risk of failure, and make the activities relevant to them. And here I would like to say one sentence here. According to Brunner, because he emphasized of like institution should arouse learners' curiosity, means this is the duty of the teacher also, ki we should arouse learner curiosity and minimize the risk of failure. This is very, very important in the present scenario. Within 2 or 3 days, we got a number of the information regarding some like if any learner cannot minimize the risk of failure, so he or she is not feeling well, like that. So this is the duty of the institution and teacher also to minimize the risk of the failure. And हम कैसे कर कैसे पाएंगे, क्योंकि हमें कुछ एक्टिविटी उस तरीके से करानी पड़ेंगी, तब हम इस तरह से कर सकते हैं. और जो ये ब्रूनर ने जो थ्योरी दी कि इंस्ट्रक्शंस को, कि जो इंस्ट्रक्शंस हैं जो है वो कैसे दिए जाएं, जो जब हम डिस्कवरी थ्योरी ऑफ लर्निंग की बात करते हैं, और डिस्कवरी थ्योरी ऑफ लर्निंग का मतलब है आपका ऑटोनोमस थ्योरी, ऑटोनोमस लर्निंग की बात कर रहे हैं, ब्रूनर की हम लोग बात कर रहे हैं, तो वो कह रहे हैं कि जो इंस्ट्रक्शंस हैं वो कैसे दिए जाएं. तो वो कह रहे हैं कि थ्योरी ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन शुड टेकन इंटू अकाउंट द वे ऑफ स्ट्रक्चरिंग नॉलेज, द प्रेजेंटेशन सिक्वेंस, द मोटिवेटिंग एक्सपीरियंस, एंड द नेचर ऑफ पेसिंग, रिवॉर्ड एंड पनिशमेंट. And in this theory of instruction, Brunner puts forth his original ideas concerning the most effective way of achieving knowledge and skills. For him, a theory of instruction should cover the following major aspects. The aspects are, the emphasis should be placed upon the learner's skill in handling things and in perceiving and grasping the subject. The learner's approach to learning should be should be able to use the acquired knowledge in solving problems. The subject matter should be presented inactively iconically and symbolically so that the learners can acquire optimal comprehension and a generalized set of a basic ideas or principle. Brunner also recognizes the role of extrinsic and intrinsic rewards in promoting learning, but he thinks that intrinsic rewards are most important, but behaviorist emphasized on extrinsic reward. And Brunner, he has emphasized on like intrinsic reward, because satisfaction gained from solving problems quickly, the interest and involvement in learning, the pleasure received from the intellectual mastery of it. So this is the reason Brunner has emphasized on intrinsic reward. And discovery learning increases motivation, strengthens the learner's tendency to carry out his or her learning activities with the autonomy that goes along with self-rewarded. It means agar लर्नर को सीख रहा है तो वो रिवॉर्ड भी खुद ही दे रहा है, उसे कहीं बाहर से देने की जरूरत नहीं है, गुड वेरी गुड या शाबाश या कोई प्राइज या कोई मेडल या इस फॉर्म में हमें कोई रीइन्फोर्समेंट नहीं देना है, बल्कि यहाँ पर जो एक ऑटोनॉमी है लर्निंग की, दैट इज सेल्फ रिवॉर्डेड. एंड डिस्कवरी लर्निंग टीचेस द लर्नर द टेक्निक्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग एंड रिजल्ट इन अ बेटर रिटेंशन ऑफ वॉट इज लर्नड बिकॉज द लर्नर एक्वायर्स द नॉलेज थ्रू हिज और हर ओन एफर्ट. जो हम सीख रहे हैं वो खुद सीख रहे हैं, इसका मतलब, और सॉरी वी कैन मतलब रियलाइज दिस थिंग कि कितना सेल्फ रिवॉर्ड हमने अपने आप को दिया है कि नहीं मैंने इतना कर लिया है या इतना सीख लिया है यहाँ पर. और ये साफ साफ आपको जाहिर करता है कि जो डिस्कवरी लर्निंग है वो ऑटोनॉमी लर्निंग की तरफ इंडिकेट करती है. तो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट डिस्कवरी लर्निंग. एंड हियर वी कैन लाइक डिफ्रेंशिएट बिहेवियरिस्ट अप्रोच ऑफ लर्निंग एंड कॉग्निटिव अप्रोच ऑफ लर्निंग. यहाँ पर थोड़ा सा हम लोग एक बार फिर थोड़ा सा रिपीट कर लें कि हम लोग ने बिहेवियरिस्ट जो बिहेवियरिज्म थ्योरी ऑफ लर्निंग की बात की थी, उसमें स्टार्टिंग हम लोगों ने थॉर्नडाइक और स्किनर से की थी. थॉर्नडाइक की हमने तीनों जो उसके नियम बताए थे उन्होंने, लॉ ऑफ रेडीनेस, लॉ ऑफ प्रैक्टिस और लॉ ऑफ इफेक्ट का, वही जो ऑपरेंट कंडीशनिंग थी जो कि स्किनर के द्वारा दी गई, और स्किनर ने रीइन्फोर्समेंट पर बहुत ज़्यादा बल दिया. और कॉग्निटिव अप्रोच में हम लोग ने जो लर्निंग है उसको सीखा कि लर्निंग इज़ अ कॉग्निटिव प्रोसेस एंड लर्निंग इज़ अ ऑटोनॉमी. एंड इसके अंदर हम लोग ने ब्रूनर को पढ़ने की कोशिश की कि ब्रूनर ने जो है वो डिस्कवरी अप्रोच की बात की और कैसे इंस्ट्रक्शन दिया जाए उसके बारे में बात की. और बिहेवियरिस्ट जो है ओवर्ट बिहेवियर की बात करता है, जबकि जो कॉग्निटिव अप्रोच है वो इंट्रिंसिक एक तरह से बिहेवियर की बात करता है. तो इस हिसाब से भी हम लोग बहुत आराम से अगर हम दोनों को लेकर चलेंगे साथ में तो वी कैन ईजिली लाइक डिफ्रेंशिएट बिहेवियरिस्ट थ्योरी ऑफ बिहेवियर अप्रोच और बिहेवियरिस्ट थ्योरीज ऑफ लर्निंग एंड कॉग्निटिव अप्रोच और कॉग्निटिव थ्योरी ऑफ लर्निंग. सो द बेसिक प्रेमिसेस ऑफ बिहेवियर अप्रोच इज लर्निंग इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ इन्वायरमेंटल कंडीशंस, स्टिमुलाई एंड रिस्पॉन्सेस. जबकि अगर हम लोग कॉग्निटिव अप्रोच को देखें तो लर्निंग इन्वॉल्व्स अ परसेप्चुअल reorganization and learning is related to insight and emphasis on information processing and human memory. And the learning formula of behaviorist approach is stimulus, response, reinforcement. While in cognitive approach, the learning formula is stimulus, cognitivist process, and the process of learning in a behaviorist approach is relationship between stimulus and response, while in like cognitive approach learning as insight. And when we talk about the entry behavior of the like in behaviorist theory, then entry behavior determines starting point from which complex behavior can be conditions. So here I'm talking about the Pavlov conditioning, ki entry behavior determines starting point from which complex behavior can be conditions. But in cognitive approach of learning, entry behavior is previous knowledge is used as a base from which a learner can develop his or her new cognitive structure. Motivation in behaviorism approach of learning is organic drives only, such as hunger, fear, anger, love, etc. While in cognitive approach of learning, goal, curiosity and expectations. So these are the high level of learning, I think, in cognitivist. And the major contribution of behaviorist theories are analysis of readiness and motivation and transfer of stimulus control, scheduling, reinforcement analysis of aversive classroom practices and individualized learning material. But the cognitivist approach of learning contributions are linking new learning to cognitive structure and providing aids in comprehension, problem solving, and long-term memory. So this is all about behaviorist and cognitive approach of learning. And here I am going to talk about Gagne views on learning. अभी तक हम लोग बात कर रहे थे कि बिहेवियरिस्ट जो व्यू है वो बिहेवियर को ज़्यादा मान्यता देता है, जबकि जो हमारा कॉग्निटिविस्ट जो थे दे आर एम्फसाइजिंग ऑन द लाइक कॉग्निशन प्रोसेस. लेकिन जो गैग्ने हैं वो लर्निंग के बारे में जब बात करते हैं तो वो कहते हैं कि यहाँ पर दोनों चीज़ें ज़रूरी हैं कि जो हमारा एक्सटर्नल जो इन्वायरमेंट है दैट इज़ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, एंड साथ में हमारा जो अपना एनवायरनमेंट है मतलब खुद का जो अंतर जो मेंटल प्रोसेस है दैट आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू गैग्ने लर्निंग इज अ प्रोसेस दैट टेक्स प्लेस इनसाइड एन इंडिविजुअल ब्रेन. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट आस्पेक्ट ऑफ अ लर्नर आर हिज सेंसेस, हिज नर्वस सिस्टम एंड हिज मसल्स. एंड गैग्ने कंबाइंड अ बेसिक बिहेवियरिस्ट पोजिशन विद एलिमेंट्स ऑफ कॉग्निटिव थॉट्स एंड बिल्ट एन हायरार्किकल मॉडल ऑफ द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द लर्निंग. And he synthesized the existing theories of learning and tried to provide a consistent application of all type of learning with the help of a set of psychological principles of learning. For example, learner learn best when information is presented in logical sequence consisting of short units with a clearer framework. And according to Gagne, conditions of learning are like 8 conditions of learning according to the Gagne. And Gagne refers to those conditions as learning type. He is primarily interested in the observable behavior and performance which are the product of these conditions. In these conditions of learning, he combined the basic behaviorist view with cognitive theory to present a hierarchical model of different types of learning. And these 8 conditions are number 1, signal learning. And signal learning means the individual acquires a conditioned response to a given signal. The learning is involuntary. It means signal learning, we are giving some signal to the learner to learn the things. Number 2, stimulus response learning. The individual makes responses to specific stimuli. The correct response is rewarded. Number 3, chaining. Chaining, two or more previously learned stimulus response connections are linked together. So here is the chaining of the stimulus response connections. Number 4, verbal association. Chains that are verbal, for example, a child identifies an object and calls it by its proper name, like red ball, blue ball, like that, or it finds as Hindi or like German, like that. Number 5, multiple discrimination. The learners learns to distinguish between motor and verbal chain which he or she has already acquired. So there is a like multiple discrimination has been started after verbal association. And after completing all 5 like stages conditions, learner will come on concept learning. Concept learning means a common response to a class of stimuli. In learning a concept, the learner responds to stimuli, identifying its abstract characteristics like its shape, color, etc. It means concept has been developed in the mind of the learner. And rule-like, it means learner is capable to frame rule. In learning a rule, we relate 2 or more concept. Means like 100 degree centigrade, water will boil. Here temperature and boiling point are 2 concepts related by a rule. So rule-like learning after concept learning. And number 8 condition is problem solving. Problem solving, in rule-like we relate 2 or more concept, while in like problem solving the learner use the rules learn to achieve some goal. Problem solving is the combined product of 2 or more lower order rules. It thus requires an internal event. Now for example, thinking to take place for solving a problem. So the 8 number condition is problem solving. So what are the basic conditions of learning according to the Gagne? Number one, signal learning. Number two, stimulus response learning. Number three, chaining. Number four, verbal association. Number five, multiple discrimination. Number six, concept learning. Number seven, roulette learning. And number eight, problem solving. So Gagne has given the idea about the hierarchy of learning, कि कैसे हम लोग बढ़ते हुए क्रम में चीज़ों को सीखते हैं. ऐसा नहीं होगा कि प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग हमारे अंदर अचानक आ जाए. सबसे पहले जो एक जो लर्नर की एज लेवल है, कि स्टार्टिंग एज में जब वो सीख रहा है तो हम सिग्नल से सिखा रहे हैं, फिर उसको हम जो है वो स्टिमुलस रिस्पॉन्स से सिखा रहे हैं, फिर हम उसे चेनिंग करा रहे हैं, फिर वर्बल एसोसिएशन हो रहा है. इस तरीके से हम लोग असेंडिंग ऑर्डर में एक हायरार्किकल क्रम में आगे बढ़ते हैं अकॉर्डिंग टू द गैग्ने. लेकिन यहाँ पर जो ध्यान रखने वाली बात यह है कि गैग्ने ने बिहेवियरिस्ट का भी लिया कुछ चीज़, और जो है कग्निशन पर भी जोर डाला साथ में. वो गैग्ने हैज आइडेंटिफाइड 9 स्टेजेस ऑफ कॉग्निटिव प्रोसेसेस दैट आर एसेंशियल टू लर्निंग विच नीड टू बी एग्जीक्यूटेड इन अ सिक्वेंशियल ऑर्डर. इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज नीड टू एग्जीक्यूटेड इन अ सिक्वेंशियल ऑर्डर एंड दीज स्टेजेस आर गेनिंग अटेंशन. सो दीज आर द स्टेजेस ऑफ कॉग्निटिव प्रोसेस. जब हम कुछ सीख रहे हैं, जब हमारी कॉग्निशन प्रोसेस चल रही है, तो हमें 9 एक तरीके से जो हमारी 9 स्टेजेस ऑफ कॉग्निटिव प्रोसेसेस हैं दैट आर वेरी एसेंशियल फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस. लाइक नंबर 1, बट इट इज़ इन सीक्वेंशियल ऑर्डर, गेनिंग अटेंशन, इन्फॉर्मिंग द लर्नर ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. नंबर 3, स्टिमुलेटिंग रिकॉल ऑफ प्री रिक्विजिट लर्निंग, प्रेजेंटिंग द स्टिमुलस मटीरियल, प्रोवाइडिंग लर्निंग गाइडेंस, eliciting the performance, providing feedback about performance correctness and assessing the performance, enhancing retention and transfer. अगर हम इन 9 स्टेजेस को फॉलो करते हैं तो जो भी कॉन्सेप्ट है उसका रिटेंशन और ट्रांसफर, रिटेंशन बहुत समय तक रहेगा उसका एंड ट्रांसफर भी उसका हम इजीली कर पाएंगे. लेकिन यहाँ पर आई एम आल्सो एम्फसाइज्ड नीड टू बी एग्जीक्यूटेड इन अ सिक्वेंशियल ऑर्डर अकॉर्डिंग टू द कॉग्निटिव process. And by sequencing instruction in this way, one create external conditions which complement the internal condition. So here external conditions and internal conditions both are very important, and these phases of learning are the typical series of external and internal events that constitute a single learning act. The internal conditions of learning includes two factors, the learner's psychological state and the cognitive processes required for learning. क्या करना है हमें यहाँ पर, कि जो लर्नर का साइकोलॉजिकल स्टेट है एंड जो कॉग्निटिव प्रोसेस है, बोथ आर इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर फॉर लर्निंग एनीथिंग. द इंटरनल प्रोसेसेस मे बी इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय द एक्सटर्नल इवेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एनवायरमेंटल स्टिमुलेशन एंड द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ दीज फेजेस. They are present in every act of learning and are performed in different ways for different varieties of learning, and they are preparation for learning, acquisition and performance, and transfer of learning. First of all, we should focus on preparation of learning, second acquisition performance, then we can transfer the understood concept in different situation. So according to Gagne, how we can prepare ourselves for learning. First of all, drawing attention, learner attention to the stimulus and informing the learners for learning and providing recall or prerequisite behavior. While in second point, acquisition of performance, we should present stimulus material permitting temporary storage of stimulus features in working memory and transferring stimulus features and related information to long-term memory, retrieving stored information, activating persons, providing information and feedback about the correctness of performance, and lastly, how we can transfer the learning. So in that way, we can provide additional cues for later recall of capacity and assessment of performances, and we should enhance retention and transfer of learning to new situations and context. Like, matlab, we should generalize the things. So this is all about, according to the Gagne, ki how we can prepare learner to transfer understood concept of learning. एंड गैगनी ने भी अपना एक मॉडल दिया इंस्ट्रक्शन का कि भाई अगर हम जो है वो मॉडल दे रहे हैं, तो उन्होंने कहा कि भाई पांच तरीके की वैरायटी है हमारी लर्निंग की। एक तो वर्बल इंफॉर्मेशन स्किल्स हैं हमारे पास, दूसरी हमारे पास इंटेलेक्चुअल स्किल्स हैं, तीसरी हमारे पास मोटर स्किल्स हैं, चौथी हमारे पास कॉग्निटिव स्ट्रेटजीज हैं, एंड फिफ्थ आर एटीट्यूड है। वो कह रहे हैं कि ईच टाइप ऑफ लर्निंग इज एक्वायर्ड इन डिफरेंट वे and that are a different set of prerequisite skills and different set of cognitive processes. And Gagne accepted that environmental stimuli are required to support the learner's cognitive process during learning. So human learning is the result of interaction between the learner, internal variable means states and cognitive processes, and the external ones also. External means instructions and stimulus. And in other word, we can say कि Gagne attempts to synthesize the basic principle of cognitivism and the behaviorism and the variety of learning we can identify in that way. Like if we are talking about verbal information skill, it means we should provide the ability to state or to recall information, and this has to be developed to meet the needs of any particular subject matter. When we talk about intellectual skill, because these are the most important ones involving mental operations, and they include conceptualization of the environment, differentiating things from each other, understanding concepts, seeing relationship between things, reading, writing, handling of numbers, and are the other abilities which come under this variety of skill. And these abilities range from the simple and the complex. And while we talk about like motor skills, they are physical skills, and these include the ability to perform sequence of physical movements. And cognitive strategies refer to the learner's thinking, remembering and learning the procedures we use for ordering and processing information internally, and they are learned over long periods of time, and attitudes are deep rooted in us, and we find it difficult to change them. They determine our predisposition towards positive or negative responses to an object, and our attitude strongly affect our motivation for learning. So this is all about Gagne hierarchy of learning and Gagne theory of learning. And Gagne theory of learning को अगर आप चाहें तो और इसको ढंग से हम लोग कर सकते हैं कि एक बार इसका Gagne hierarchy of learning, जब Gagne theory of learning है उसमें तीन चीज़ों को हमें basically देखना पड़ेगा, पहले prerequisite behavior, और second learner's characteristics, and third cognitive process and instructions. तो अगर हम तीन चीज़ों को देखकर चलेंगे तो Gagne के अनुसार हम लर्निंग करा पाएंगे. और जहाँ पर वो कहते हैं कि प्रीरिक्विजिट बिहेवियर का मतलब क्या है कि प्रोसेस ऑफ लर्निंग मूव फ्रॉम द सिंपल टू द कॉम्प्लेक्स एंड द लर्नर हैज़ टू डेवलप रिक्विजिट कैपेबिलिटीज बिफोर एक्वायर्स न्यू टर्मिनल बिहेवियर. सो द यूज ऑफ एन हायरार्की ऑफ लर्निंग एंड टास्क एनालिसिस आर इंटीग्रल पार्ट ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शनल ट्रांजिशंस. इट मीन्स वी शुड फोकस ऑन प्रीरिक्विजिट बिहेवियर ऑफ द लर्नर, देन वी शुड नो अबाउट द लाइक लर्नर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स लाइक इंडिविजुअल डिफरेंसेज, रेडीनेस एंड मोटिवेशन टू लर्न द इम्पॉर्टेंट इश्यू टू बी कंसिडर्ड बिफोर डिजाइनिंग इंस्ट्रक्शनल एक्टिविटीज एंड कग्निशन प्रोसेस एंड इंस्ट्रक्शन. The transfer of learning, the self-management skill of the learner and teacher-learner, the skill of problem-solving are integral part of the internal conditions of learning applicable to instruction. The skill of learning how to learn should be developed in the learner, and the emphasis should be on the learner individuality. तो अगर हम prerequisite behavior, learner characteristics और कैसे cognition process होगी, कैसे instruction दिए जाएंगे, इन सब चीज़ों का ध्यान रखते हैं, तो हम बहुत आसानी से signal learning से चलते हुए जो है problem solving तक पहुँचेंगे कि how we can solve the problem. So this is all about behaviorism theory of learning and cognitive theory of learning. And अभी भी बहुत सारी थ्योरीज हैं लर्निंग की, जिस जो कि अकॉर्डिंग टू द सिचुएशन एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द इन्वायरमेंट लर्नर अडॉप्ट करता है कि किस सिचुएशन में हमें किस तरीके से सीखना है. ऐसा नहीं है कि जब आपकी एज कम है तो आप जो है वो सिग्नल लर्निंग का इस्तेमाल करेंगे और कम एज में ही आप जो है एक तरह से कॉग्निटिव जो अप्रोच ऑफ लर्निंग का इस्तेमाल करना शुरू कर देंगे. तो जैसा इन्वायरमेंट और जैसा हमारा इंटरेक्शन है उस इन्वायरमेंट के साथ में, किस तरीके से हमें सीखना है और जो नेचर क्या है चीज़ों को सीखने का, कि हमें कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर्मेशन करना है या सिर्फ हम चीज़ों को जनरलाइज करना चाहते हैं. तो अकॉर्डिंग टू द सिचुएशन एंड एनवायरमेंट ऑफ द लर्नर वी शुड अडॉप्ट द प्रोसेस ऑफ लर्निंग. लेकिन सबसे बड़ा जो एजुकेशनल इम्प्लीकेशन जो बिहेवियरिस्ट थ्योरी का रहा कि हाउ टू राइट ऑब्जेक्टिव्स इन बिहेवियर टर्म एंड हाउ टू डिज़ाइन लाइक इंस्ट्रक्शनल स्ट्रेटजी, दिस वॉज द इम्प्लीकेशन ऑफ लाइक कॉग्निटिव अप्रोच ऑफ लर्निंग. तो यहाँ पर बिहेवियरिस्ट का एजुकेशनल इम्प्लीकेशंस क्या है, बिहेवियरिज्म का, कॉग्निटिविज्म का जो है एजुकेशनल इम्प्लीकेशंस क्या है, और यहाँ इतना दोनों थ्योरीज को एक साथ लेने के साथ में ये समझ में आता है कि बोथ द थ्योरीज आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द थ्योरीज लर्निंग हैज़ इट्स ओन डेफिनेशन अकॉर्डिंग टू द बिहेवियरिस्ट एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द कॉग्निटिविस्ट. लेकिन दोनों ही चीज़ें इंपॉर्टेंट हैं. जो बिहेवियरिज्म थ्योरी है वो एक्सटर्नल इन्वायरमेंट पे बात कर रही है, स्टिमुलस रिस्पॉन्स और रीइन्फोर्समेंट पर बात कर रही है, और जो कॉग्निटिविस्ट थ्योरी है लर्निंग की वो बात कर रही है इंटरनल स्टेट ऑफ माइंड ऑफ द लर्नर की. बट बोथ द थ्योरीज आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द नेचर ऑफ द थ्योरीज लर्निंग इज़ हैविंग डिफरेंट डिफरेंट डेफिनेशन. बट इन कंक्लूजन वी कैन से दैट लर्निंग इज़ अ कंटिन्यूस प्रोसेस एंड लर्निंग इज़ अ कॉम्प्लेक्स एक्टिविटीज ऑल्सो. एंड इन द लर्निंग प्रोसेस फीडबैक इज़ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड इन सम सर्टेन स्टेज ऑफ लर्निंग रीइन्फोर्समेंट इज ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. तो वी शुड एम्फसाइज द एक्सटर्नल इन्वायरमेंट एंड वी शुड नो द इंटरनल स्टेट ऑफ द लर्नर ऑल्सो टू लर्न समथिंग. अकॉर्डिंगली वी शुड अप्लाई टीचिंग लर्निंग प्रोसेस एंड टीचिंग लर्निंग स्ट्रेटजीज इन आर क्लासरूम. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट, वी हैव कवर्ड मोस्टली 3 पॉइंट्स इन दिस लेक्चर, कि मीनिंग ऑफ लर्निंग. एंड इन मीनिंग ऑफ लर्निंग इट इज़ ऑल्सो डिवाइडेड इंटू 3 पार्ट, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ लर्निंग एंड स्टेजेस ऑफ कंडीशंस ऑफ लर्निंग एंड अप्रोचेज ऑफ लर्निंग. एंड नंबर टू वी हैव टेकन लाइक बिहेवियरिज्म थ्योरी ऑफ लर्निंग एंड नंबर 3 पॉइंट वी हैव टेकन कॉग्निटिविस्ट थ्योरी ऑफ लर्निंग. एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो लर्न्ड अबाउट द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन बिहेवियरिज्म थ्योरी एंड कॉग्निटिविस्ट थ्योरी. सो दिस इज़ ऑल अबाउट माई प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ टूडे एंड आई एम रियली थैंकफुल टू ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर लिसनिंग मी पेशेंसली. इन माई नेक्स्ट लेक्चर आई टेक अप ह्यूमनिज्म थ्योरी एंड अदर थ्योरीज ऑफ लर्निंग. एंड थैंक यू ऑल फॉर लिसनिंग मी पेशेंसली. नमस्कार.